The ascension process is progressing in a way that I could never have imagined, even as little as 2, 3, or 4 years ago. It is nothing like I would have expected. In fact, it is so vastly different that I find myself often questioning, how is this reality in any way tied to the reality that I grew up in? I'm moving into energies and going through processes and having experiences that were completely off of my radar. And that's what I want to talk about in this video. As you move forward through the ascension process, you're going to be encountering situations and experiences that you really didn't expect. And that's the whole point of this. I know when I first awakened, I started having my guides come through and the galactics came forward. All this amazing stuff, synchronicities and signs and communication with deceased relatives. Incredible, amazing things were happening. Now, at that point, the body is at a lower frequency. We're operating at a lower frequency, okay? Even our thoughts at that point is at a lower frequency. That's why a lot of the experiences that we have then seem very magical, because we're seeing or experiencing the higher frequency energy as it comes down through our field in a way that really aligns with our beliefs and limitations and our programming. For a lot of people, it could be religious programming. However, you were your upbringing, what your parents have taught you when you were little, things like that. Maybe movies and television shows you used to watch when you were younger programmed you to think of reality in a certain way. And when it comes to experiencing your higher frequency self as it lands in the body and your frequency starts rising, you have a set of limiting beliefs there that really create a reality or situational reality as to how that energy is going to manifest in a lower dimensional field. So we'll see ET craft and orbs and light and all sorts of things like that, that from the human perspective are really a separate type of a scenario, a situation, something that's happening externally. Now, as your body rises in frequency, things really start to change, because all that was out here, all that was represented by your higher frequency stepping down through your field, through your energetic field and landing in your body. That's how you experience it from the perspective of the human. But as that energy integrates and your physical body starts to rise, the way you experience reality changes vastly. And that's something that when you first start going through this healing journey, you really didn't have or were able to grasp what that reality, that higher frequency reality, really could look like. Okay. Because when you thought about it, where are we going on this ascension process? You were still operating from those lower frequency limiting beliefs. But you go through the healing process, your body starts rising in frequency, a whole new reality starts to manifest out of that. And it's vastly different from what you might have expected it to look like when you started on that journey. And I'm going through that right now. I'm going through a growth phase. I've been through numerous phases like that. But the phase I'm going through now is very, very interesting, because it is so different from anything that I've experienced before. Everything is very almost dreamlike. It's a dreamlike kind of state. I feel a huge expansiveness happening. The ties to the old dense reality almost feel like an old energetic signature or hologram that is no longer finitely defined, if that makes any sense. It's far less dense. It's almost like I'm looking at a residual energetic hologram, something that my senses know so well because I've experienced it as I was growing up and in my adult life up until this point. But yet, energetically, it is far less dense. I'm still experiencing it, but I'm seeing it as an old energetic reality, an old energetic hologram that simply shows up because there's still a little bit of neural circuitry in me that is affixed to that old reality. So it's almost like a very loose framework. So as we go through the ascension process, the framework that you have put on reality, the attention, the intention that manifests into the third dimensional reality, as you rise in frequency, that is going to change, that is going to loosen. And what was so real to you, so firm, so fixed, is going to start to turn into more of an energetic residual of a reality that is being left behind as you detach from it. Now, this expansiveness I'm feeling is very, very interesting because it feels like almost like you're just a huge satellite dish. And I've gone through a lot of the healing where I've detached from a lot of the programming and the limiting beliefs. And I'm finding myself in a state of mind now where I'm a lot more open to the unexpected. Okay. And as you rise in frequency, you're going to find yourself being more open to the unexpected. That's natural as you release the chains of your limiting beliefs or your very fixed version or definition of reality, what you would expect reality to look like. Maybe when you were growing up, that was very fixed, very programmed on a timeline. We're rising in frequency and reality is now changing very rapidly. But when we step back or we heal from just the expectation that things are supposed to go a certain way, we have like this broad satellite dish and it's very expansive. And we find ourselves just sitting there allowing all the new to come through. So we're not so much holding on to the old. We're allowing new to come through. And that's what I'm experiencing now. I've detached from a lot of my old limiting beliefs around like societal types of things, around money, around expectations. And that, a lot of the 3D stuff, those chains have dissolved. And I'm more open to allowing this energy to move through me. And it's moving me into this more of a dreamlike state. Now, as the body rises in frequency and enters the fourth dimensional field, your higher self has landed, more of it has landed, and it is starting to perceive reality through the human avatar. Okay, so you're going to start to have that kind of a weirdness kind of feel, okay, day after day after day with me. It's a very loose kind of open kind of dreamlike state, which makes sense as we're moving up through the fourth dimensional field physically. Okay, I'm not talking frequency-wise, where you have the ability to extend up into fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth dimensional fields and really resonate to that frequency. We all have the ability to do that. I'm talking about the frequency of the physical body. Okay, so as we go through this healing process and the molecules, the atoms, the particles within your body start vibrating faster as more of your higher self lands, you're going to find yourself in a reality that is less dense. That's as we move into the fourth dimensional field. And with that, things become so much more pliable. Makes sense, right? That the old 3D reality is not going to have that fixedness that it had, that density that it had. It's going to be more representative of a just like a residual energy field. Okay, so I look around and I see my same reality, but it's a lot less fixed. It seems to me more pliable. And as we do that, we are pulling out of the linear time line and we're moving more into a quantum field. So we're open to infinite potential possibilities. And that's when things start to manifest very, very quickly. So you could use your thoughts and your intent, because you've detached a lot, you've healed a lot of that subconscious programming, and you've detached a lot from your thoughts. Okay, especially thoughts when it pertains to triggers and anxieties and worries and things like that. You're able to create space, you're able to experience that energy and feel it, because that's still going to happen. We're still in a physical body, in a physical, represented as a physical being, but it's a body that's operating at a higher frequency. So there's more light active within the body, more of your DNA is active. So you have more consciousness present. So you're able to really experience those triggers in a different way, feel that energy, and consciously redirect your thoughts in this new field of reality that is far less affixed. And when you could do that and add your conscious intent to your thoughts, bring awareness to your thoughts, you're going to start to really have a more instantaneous effect on the field that you're finding yourself in, the frequency field. So if it's a fourth dimensional field, from the perspective of the human and the body, things are going to become more pliable. The other thing I want to mention is a lot of your fears are going to be coming up as the body starts moving up through the fourth dimensional field. It's going to need to shed the density, okay, and the programming that's kind of been hidden. We've been doing a lot of surface work. As it moves up, in order for it to get up into that fourth dimensional field, the physical body, it's going to need to really shed some of that deep layers, the deep, dense, energetic layers that are anchoring it to a 3D field. So a lot of that stuff for many of you is going to be coming up now. It's be coming up really, really quickly. But you're going to find, since you have a lot more consciousness grounded, that you're going to deal with it or handle it or respond to it far differently than you would have maybe even as little as 6 months ago. Okay, so you're going to be able to feel something very, very new within you that gives you a sense of guidance, intuitive guidance on how to navigate the healing journey as these denser triggers come up. And the more you can find that within you, then it's going to represent, it's going to feel like peace. It's going to feel like trust and love. You're going to be able to activate that and bring it forward. And your body is going to continue to heal at an accelerated rate and move up in frequency more through the fourth dimensional field. Okay. All the while your body is moving up in frequency, you're accessing higher states of awareness. Okay, higher frequencies of consciousness are available to you to tune into. Okay, so we extend that antenna, we go up into the higher dimensional fields, and then we're able to ground more of that energy into the body, and that rises, okay, raises the frequency of the physical vessel. And again, reality is going to become a lot less fixed and more pliable and more controllable by your thoughts. So be aware of the power that you have. I want you to notice when something triggers you, are you feeling or experiencing something new within that is giving you a level of comfort that maybe you hadn't felt before, or knowing or knowledge of how to move through a situation that may have previously created fear or anxiety for you? If you guys have experienced that recently, drop a comment. I'd love to hear about it, because I've been going through a lot of that over the past few weeks. But really, since the beginning of the year, things have really, really accelerated. And I'm finding myself in a new state of awareness about what's happening within me and what's happening around me. And I'm really feeling an expanded level of consciousness. And that is more of my higher self grounding and integrating. So a lot of that stuff externally that I used to perceive is now coming through internally as knowing. Okay, so a lot of the, you know, synchronistic events, a lot of the guide communication, things like that have shifted to an external type of thing, because when we're in a 3D field, this energy comes in, we experience it externally. That's what the third dimensional field's for. As we move up and our body moves up in a fourth dimensional field, we really start to integrate that light and things kind of shift. It turns more into a knowing and intuitive guidance, internal conversations and things like that. So that's what I've been going through. I still have the ability to reflect out, if I choose to, my guides and experience them that way. But for the most part, it's just all coming through as a knowing now, which is so, so amazing. So like I said in the beginning of this video, things are happening in a way that I could not have anticipated or expected. And that's a very important point I want to reiterate again, because when we have expectations of how a process is supposed to go, we're limiting that process to what the mind can perceive. Okay. And as you're going through these, you know, these healing journeys, I've talked about a Ferris wheel before, where it's like a, you know, healing and, you know, you're feeling good, you're feeling bad, you're feeling good, you're feeling bad. So as we go through the process, we continue along that, and it's a slow uptrend every time you go through these cycles, right? Like a spiral staircase. But we experience this energy. And as you go through that a number of times, at some point, you know, your body gets to a frequency where something's going to trigger you, and you're going to actually sense something internally that you had never sensed before. And that is because of all of those ups and downs that you've gone through. You've been doing the healing work, the clearing, creating the space, grounding more of that energy. It just so happens that now something changed within to where you're able to perceive your higher self from in here. Connect with that heart space, connect with your solar plexus, have that inner sense of power, that gut feeling, that intuition becomes louder because of the healing work that you've done. So if you're still going through these cycles of like little dark night of the soul type of cycles, know that you are healing. You may not be aware of it right now, but there will come a point where your body rose in frequency enough to integrate enough of your higher frequency energy, enough of your higher self to where you actually can feel it as you're triggered. Okay, so hang in there if you're going through that. I know things will improve, but it is so, so important to let go of an expectation as to how this is going to happen, how this process is going to unfold. There's a lot of talks about the galactics, the galactic wars. A lot of that stuff's happening in the fourth dimensional field. We're moving up through the fourth dimensional field. But again, that's a manifestation of aspects of us, aspects of you in different realities and at different frequencies. So it's all part of the same thing. But let's try to not lock ourselves in to a certain storyline, because again, that limits your potential, that limits your experience, that limits your consciousness. Okay. And we don't want to do that. We want to have that broad satellite dish and be open to the energy of you that is coming down and landing, and be open to how this process is going to unfold in ways that you can't anticipate. And just go with it. We always talk about going with the flow. Go with the flow. Okay. Let go of the expectations. Feel what's happening with your body. Notice what's happening with your five senses, and notice how it feels different and how something is connecting up within when you experience something through the five senses. You're not solely operating according to the five senses anymore. There's a sixth sense. Your higher self has come down and has landed and is continuing to. And we want to add that to the equation. So we detach from the feedback that our senses are giving us, and we allow ourselves to process that information through something that is new, that has landed within you. And that changes the whole reality, changes the whole picture. But in order to allow that to happen with as little resistance as possible, is to let go of any expectations as to how that's going to unfold. Stay present, stay grateful, feel the love, feel the joy, and observe everything that is coming forward. And just imagine the magical possibilities that can manifest from this entire amazing process. Thank you.